This pile of broken electric scooters seems never ending.
Sometimes I just think, what did I get myself into?
Ben Baker took on the slew of spin scooters in August. About 8,000 of them were headed straight for the landfill.
We got these for recycling from a company called Spin. They had upgraded their scooters, and these were actually all gathering up in their Cleveland warehouse from all over the country.
Mounds upon mounds sit outside Ben's electronic recycling company, Summit E-Waste.
We get the occasional person stopping by wondering what's going on with them.
They're also stored in buses. But wait, there's more. I'm in the basement of Summit E-Waste, and piles of hundreds of scooters are all around me. Ben says he actually checked with the fire inspector to make sure these piles were safe. The inspector said as long as these scooters weren't plugged in, it should be okay.
Why keep these out of the landfill?
Well, they have lithium batteries in them, every one of them, large lithium battery packs down here in the bottom, which you don't want that in the landfill seeping into the water.
This warehouse on Lakeside Avenue in Cleveland is where those scooters were stored, according to Spin. The company says it no longer operates in Cleveland. It expects Summit E-Waste will responsibly recycle the scooters. A task Summit E-Waste thinks will take the team years to complete.
It took a long time to figure out how they function and how to get them running. It took me hundreds of man hours.
One by one, each defunct scooter gets rolling again. The tedious job includes replacing the circuit board and software system.
We've got to connect to it. Power on. There we go. They have a top speed of 22 miles an hour, and they're controllable with a smartphone. So if you do have younger teenagers who are riding them and you don't want them to go 22 miles an hour, you can limit the speed and they are unable to change it themselves. You can turn the headlight on and off.
Operated right off your smartphone, Ben says people are already buying the scooters. From trash to travel, Ben's goal is to give all 8,000 a whole new life.
It does worry me that once the new fad popularity of it dies out, that there's a lot of scooters that are going to be thrown away. All the waste will stay out of the landfills because they're being reused as full working units, which is great.
In Akron, Tessa DiTiro, News 5.